Hi, I'm Olga, and in this video, we'll see how to approve timesheets, expenses, and time off in Clockify. We'll also see how to set up and manage your approval flow. So let's dive right in. An approval period for time entries and expenses can be set for different time periods: weekly, semi-monthly, or monthly. You can also choose who approves time, either team managers or project managers. Team managers approve whole timesheets of the people they manage. Project managers approve a portion of the submitted timesheet that concerns only the projects they're assigned to manage. And admins approve whole timesheets for everyone on the workspace. Also, you can log dates according to your approval period to prevent users from adding additional time for past weeks. You can log time or expense edits before a specific date and manually update the date after every approval period. Automatically lock edits on a certain day on a weekly or monthly basis. Or lock changes for entries that are older than a certain number of days, weeks, or months. To be approved, time entries and expenses must first be logged and submitted, either through the time tracker or timesheet. You can submit them for approval either via the web app or the mobile app. Once you submit for approval, all unapproved time entries and expenses in that period will get a pending approval label. Users can still edit submitted time and expenses before they get approved. Once approved, time and expenses can't be further edited neither by users nor admins. When a member makes an approval request, a person responsible for the approval will receive an email notification. If team managers are in charge of the approval, they will get an email when their team members submit time. If project managers are in charge of approval, then all project managers whose project is in the submitted timesheet will be notified. And finally, when a request is approved or rejected, the user will be notified as well. You can glance over the total submitted hours and approve all with one click, or review requests and approve them one by one. When you open an approval request, you will see a visual breakdown of log time as well as each individual time entry. If the time record has incorrect or incomplete information, you can correct it right from there, or reject it and leave a note to the team member with instructions on what to fix before they submit it again. Once the time is approved, it can no longer be changed by anyone, including admins. If there's a mistake, you'll need to withdraw approval, in which case a permanent record of the original approval remains in the archive for audit purposes. The Archive tab lists all previously approved or withdrawn time entries, where you can filter them by date, team, or status. And in the Unsubmitted tab, you can see users who have no recorded time, so you can remind them to log it. Time off requests have a separate approval process. You first set time off policies, choose who approves them, and give people days or hours they can spend. Then, people request time off, and the person responsible for the approval either approves or rejects the request. Requests can be filtered based on their status as pending, approved, or rejected, as well as based on team members and dates. You can approve time off requests, reject them, or reject already approved requests if they were made by accident. Approval can be managed by admins who can approve time, expenses, or time off for anyone, or by team managers who can do so for their team members. You can remind team managers to approve pending requests for their team members. And also, from the Unsubmitted tab, you will be able to directly remind team members to submit time or expenses if the approval period has started. Users without time are also visible in the weekly reports as well. If you have the permissions, you can also review and correct time entries for other members in the detailed report, either one by one or in bulk. You can customize your exports and get approval information for each time entry in an Excel file, like who approved it and when. In detailed report, you can also add time for others and perform time audits for entries that have a suspicious duration or missing information, such as task or project. To minimize incomplete time entries, you can set time entry fields as required, whether it's for projects, tasks, tag, description, or any custom field you've created. To learn more about reports and other Clockify features, be sure to check out our other videos. Thank you for watching.